ಸೈನಿಕರೊಂದಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಸಂಜೆ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಇತ್ತೀಚೆಗೆ ನಡೆಯಿತು.
ಲಯನ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲಬ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ 312 ಇದರ ವತಿಯಿಂದ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಕನ್ಸಲ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸಿವಿಲ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಮಂಗಳೂರು ಘಟಕದ ಸಹಯೋಗದೊಂದಿಗೆ ಸೈನಿಕರೊಂದಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಸಂಜೆ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಇತ್ತೀಚೆಗೆ ಸಂತ ಸೆಬೆಸ್ಟಿಯನ್ ಸಭಾಂಗಣದಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೆಯಿತು. ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಲಯನ್ಸ್ ಜಿಲ್ಲಾ ಗವರ್ನರ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಗೀತ್ ಪ್ರಕಾಶ್ ಉದ್ಘಾಟಿಸಿ ಮಾತನಾಡಿದರು.
Association of Civil Engineers and the Lions Fraternity and the War Veterans, together we are going to have a great evening today. When we thought of this, we were about to have a program on Vijay Diwas in December, but because of the circumstances we have to postpone the program, and the coordinator for Alliance Youth Camp and Youth Exchange and Youth Empowerment, Engineer Land Vijay Vishnubhaiya, along with Nanda Gopal, Sachidananda Gopal, and all the other associated faculties of our team, has thought of this great evening. And today we are all here to hear from the war veterans their experiences and instill some good points to save our country and serve our country for the children, the upcoming youth, to have a commitment for saving our country and work for our country.
ಈ ಸಂದರ್ಭ 1971 ಇಂಡಿಯೋ ಪಾಕ್ ಯುದ್ಧದಲ್ಲಿ ತನ್ನ ಕಾಲುಗಳನ್ನು ಕಳೆದುಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದ ಮೇಜರ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಇಯಾನ್ ಕಾರ್ಡೋಜಾ ದಿಲ್ಲಿಯಿಂದ ವರ್ಚುವಲ್ ವೇದಿಕೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸಂದೇಶ ನೀಡಿದರು.
ಮೈ ನೇಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಯಾನ್ ಕಾರ್ಡೋಜಾ. ಐ ಆಮ್ ರಿಟೈರ್ಡ್ ಆಫೀಸರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಆರ್ಮಿ. ಇನ್ 1971 ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ವೆಂಟ್ ಟು ವಾರ್ ವಿತ್ ಪಾಕಿಸ್ತಾನ್ ವನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಫಾರ್ 9 days and 9 nights, ಫೈಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಎನಿಮಿ ವಿದೌಟ್ ಫುಡ್, ವಿದೌಟ್ ವಾಟರ್, ವಿತ್ ರಿಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಅಮ್ಯುನಿಷನ್. But we struck terror into the hearts of the Pakistanis by the use of the Kukri during the battle for the capture of Sylhet. Towards the end, I stepped on a landmine and my leg got very badly injured. I asked the doctor to go and find something to cut off my leg. He went away, and he was away for a very long time. So I asked my backman, where is my Kukri? So he said, here it is, sir. I said, the doctor is taking too long, give it to me. So I cut off my leg and I told him to go out and bury it. After that, I was evacuated to a number of Indian hospitals, military hospitals, finally reaching Pune at the Artificial Limb Center. I got my leg and I started walking, I started running, I started doing my exercises, I started climbing. And unfortunate part is, at that time, the army rule was that people who lose a limb in battle or otherwise cannot command troops. And I was told that henceforward, I will only be a staff officer. That means I'll be doing a Babu's job. So I said, what is your problem? I'm as good as anybody with two legs, or even better than them. So they said, you have to prove it. And so I started training. And I did the battle physical efficiency test, leaving 7 officers with 2 legs behind me. I climbed 4,800 feet. And the vice chief, I was staff officer too, came down in a helicopter and he said, how did you come here? So I said, I climbed. He said, you can climb. I said, sir, there are many things that we can do which our senior officers would understand. He asked for my file and he said, yes, give him a battalion and all other war wounded officers who are not taking shelter of their wounds. When the East Pakistan conceded defeat and surrendered to the Indian Army, 95,000 prisoners were captured, the largest number since World War II. My battalion, 4-5 Gurkha Rifles, played an important part in this war. We launched the last Kukri attack in modern military history at a place called Atgram. We captured Ghazipur. We launched the first heli-borne attack by the Indian Army at a place called Sylhet, 50 kilometers behind enemy lines. At that battle, we fought for 9 days, 9 nights, without food, without water, without medical supplies. Our ratio was 1 Indian to 20 Pakistanis. 3 brigadiers, 2 full colonels, 173 officers, 290 JCOs and 8,000 troops surrendered to us. There are many lessons to be learned. The most important is cooperation in every walk of life. Never be afraid and never give up. Thank you for listening. Jai Hind.
ಈ ಸಂದರ್ಭ 1971 ಇಂಡಿಯೋ ಪಾಕ್ ಯುದ್ಧದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿದ ಜಿಲ್ಲೆಯ 5 ಮಾಜಿ ಸೈನಿಕರಾದ ಬ್ರಿಗೇಡಿಯರ್ ಐಎನ್ ರೈ, ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಟನ್ ವಸಂತ್ ಕೆ, ಕಮಾಂಡರ್ ಜೆಪಿ ಮಸ್ಕರೇನಸ್, ಸಬ್ ಕರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಸಿ ಭದ್ರಯ್ಯ, ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಸರ್ಜೆಂಟ್ ಬಿ ಸಚ್ಚಿದಾನಂದ ಶೆಟ್ಟಿ ಅವರನ್ನು ಸನ್ಮಾನಿಸಿ ಗೌರವಿಸಲಾಯಿತು.
Our soldiers are our pride, and one such pride of our nation is Captain Vasant, who was born in the same year that our Bharat got its independence, 1947. He joined the service in 1965 after his completion of his BCom, and he served for 28 years and 7 days. When I just see the service of Captain Vasant, I am reminded of Shafak's words, East, West, South and North makes little difference. No matter what your destination is, just be sure that every journey is a journey within. And if you have traveled within, you'll travel the whole world, which is so true of Captain Vasant, as he has served in all 4 directions of our country.
These small days are busy felicitating honoring Captain Vasant sir. Let's all get busy by applauding, but this is the least we could do to pay our respect to these great servicemen of India. Let us all join our hands together, make some noise and congratulate for the extreme service they have provided all throughout these years. Ish Kamath on stage to introduce.
It gives me immense sense of pride to introduce a war veteran who has served our motherland through Indian Navy for 31 plus years. He was born on 11th November 1936 in the family of late William and Fidget Mascarenhas, completed his early schooling in St. Aloysius School, and he joined Navy as a boy entry after his 10th grade. Here began a great journey of serving Indian Navy and our country. He became an officer in Indian Navy in the year 1959, and soon after that he got an opportunity to be a landing party at Anjadeep Island in the Operation of Liberation of Goa in 1961 war. His journey as a naval officer was filled with thrills and spills, wherein he got an opportunity to serve on board frigates, destroyers, aircraft carriers and INS Vikrant. He was also platoon commander in garrison based in Andaman Island and also officer in charge of landing craft captured in 1971 war at Port Blair. He served as a commanding officer of 5th Navy Unit NCC Mangalore, officer discharge of Naval Coast Battery at Goa, and has also undergone training capture of submarine and merchant vessels at sea.
You will note in our words, he's just 87 years young. So let's pay our honors to Commander GP Mass Minister here. Let the applause not stop. Chappale, Joragi Bandra Matra, Chappale, Balai, Rodhagari, Joraga, Chappale, Mukandra, Namanagarana, E. Hiriya, Sadhakrige, Salisona. For the next few felicitations, I would like to.
Life is truly wicked. You have to pay a price for everything. The altar of a good job demands it. Here is a striking example of a submariner who walked on the razor's edge but returned home unscathed. Born to Srimati Sushilamma and late Channa Basappa Gowda, he grew up in Siddhapur Taluk in Uttar Kannada. He completed his matriculation from a municipal school at Sagar and went on to do his diploma in electrical engineering from Government Polytechnic College, Kargar. He worked for a short time at MSEB and MISL Bhadravati and then joined the Indian Navy in 1970. He completed his basic training of 6 months in Mumbai, basic electrical training of 6 months in Jamnagar, basic submarine training of 6 months in Vishakhapatnam, and topped it up with a basic training of 18 months from Vladivostok, USSR, in 1975-76. Fully equipped with the knowledge and polished to perfection, he was posted at the Harbour Security Force in Vishakhapatnam. Later, he was posted on board the submarine which took part in the dangerous war patrolling in the Arabian Sea. But nothing could deter his spirit, courage, and love for his country. Just before retiring from the Indian Navy, he worked as an instructor in the submarine training school in Vishakhapatnam. And after retiring, he did not hang up his boots. He worked in MDL and Dredging Corporation of India Limited. Now, he spends his life doing meaningful service at the Lions Club. Blissfully married to Pushparani, she has immersed herself in the services of the poor. They have 2 sons and a granddaughter. Ladies and gentlemen, MC Badraya Phul.
It is my honor and privilege to speak about our keynote speaker on this solemn ceremony. Brigadier Iron Rai, he completed his high school and college from St. Aloysius College, Mangalore, in 1968 as a BSc Botany and Zoology graduate. As a student, he was senior under officer of Mangalore Group NCC. Twice best cadet, member of the shooting team, and attended army attachment camp and mountaineering courses. He was a middle distance runner and member of basketball and volleyball team. He joined the Academy for Commission Training in 1969 and in 1970 got into SIP Light Infantry as second lieutenant. As a young officer, he was a commando, platoon commander during the 1971 Indo-Pak War. In the western sector, his regiment was tasked to capture a Pakistani post in Lahore front during the assault at midnight on 11 December 1971, he led a rifle company of 100 soldiers. It was one of the bloodiest battles in 1971 war. That night his regiment lost 3 officers and 48 brave soldiers. 2 officers and 82 men were injured. 2 of Lieutenant Rai's buddies, roommates, were martyred. Pakistanis left the post and ran away behind, leaving behind their casualties. From 1973 to 1976, as a captain, he was involved in operations against Naga guerrillas in the malaria and leech-infested jungles of Nagaland. It was during this period the Nagas had challenged the government to hold elections. After a brief respite and promotion as a major, he served in Ladakh at altitude of 15,500 feet, facing the Chinese and braving minus 35 degree temperature along the line of control in East Ladakh. He was then selected to go to the prestigious Officers Training Academy to impart training to officer cadets for pre-commission training from 1985 to 87 at Chennai. From Chennai, he moved to join his regiment in Sri Lanka as part of Indian peacekeeping forces. In one of the major actions against Tamil Tigers, LTTE, he was critically wounded, evacuated by helicopter to Jaffna, airlifted to Chennai, and then to the Air Force Hospital, Bangalore. He remained in ICU for 3 months and another 3 months in hospital, underwent 3 surgeries. Against medical advice, he returned voluntarily to Sri Lanka to be with his soldiers and continued to take part in operations against Tamil Tigers.
Learning Bangalore, presenting this citation. The harder the battle, the sweeter is the victory. December 16, 1971 is etched in the history of independent India in golden letters as our soldiers reigned supreme on war front, exhibiting utmost bravery, leadership, strategic acumen and unfathomable sacrifice. As citizens of this great democracy, it's our wanton duty to remember and revere the martyrdom of our brave hearts and also salute all those who are part of this glorious past, thus recognizing the dedication, commitment and service to our motherland. This citation is a mark of honor and pride that we bestow upon you.
All of us present here, all the ex-servicemen, we owe you a lot, but this is a small way of presenting our honor and respect to you people. Thank you so much. Definitely will be following your foot trails.
ಇದೇ ವೇಳೆ 1971 ಯುದ್ಧ ವಿಜಯದ ಸುವರ್ಣ ಮಹೋತ್ಸವದ ಹಿನ್ನೆಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವರ್ಣಿಮ ವಿಜಯ ವರ್ಷ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ಚಾಲನೆ ನೀಡಲಾಯಿತು.
Dream come true for me and Maya. We've been planning this kind of get together, or rather an occasion to honor ourselves by being with all of you. So indeed we are blessed that we have amidst you who inspire us all, especially the next generation, to take up national cause, that is to take up causes that bring better tomorrow. We are a nation which blames, but then here are men who inspire us to act. There is no question of blaming when the enemy soldier is in the eyeball to eyeball range. There is no question of blaming or procrastinating when there is an emergency declared on the borders. We are used to all these vices. Vidura Neeti says a beautiful shloka where it says Shat doshaha purusheneva, means there are six doshas or bad qualities in us. They are Nidra, Tandra, Bayam, Krodaha, Alasyam, Dirga Sutrata. Nidra, sleep. Tandra, kind of lethargy. Bhayam, anger. Krodaha, bhayam, fear. Krodaha, anger. And alasyam, alasyam is laziness. And Dirga Sutrata, procrastination. All these six will not be found in these men who are in uniform. And that is the beauty of men in uniform, right from day one of their service to the day they say goodbye to life. The discipline and the culture that they carry is an inspiration to all. And in lines of our Prime Minister's call to observe Swarnim Vijay Varsh, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has lit the Swarnim Vijay torch in Delhi. And these four torches are going to the hometowns of the four Paramveer Chakra awardees of 1971. How many of us know this? So, there's a lot of awareness that we need to create. And also, there's a lot of work that we need to do in terms of nation building in our own way. Nation building is not just about going to the borders, fighting the enemy and coming back alive or wrapped in the tricolor. There's a lot of things that we need to do in nation building. Planting a sapling is also patriotism. In our apartment culture today, loving our neighbor or knowing our neighbor is also patriotism in a way. So friends, Center for Integrated Learning has taken the onus to work with children and youth on various aspects of personality development and social sensitization. And today, it's our pleasure to join hands with organizations like Lions International, Lions Club Mangalore, DK District Ex-Servicemen Association, Engineers Association, and so many others to launch this Swarnim Vijay Varsh in our own way.
So here we are launching Swarnim Vijay Varsh, the prestigious celebration that is happening all throughout this year. The logo is being launched here, and henceforth a lot of activities will be in commemorating the 50 years of the 1971 war.
अपनी सरहद तक सागर की हद तक हम निगे बाद है धरती अंबर तक.
The Indian Armed Forces are taking retaliatory measures to repel Pakistani aggression. The Mukti Bahini gains strength.
दुश्मन भारत का जिंदा नहीं बचेगा जग में.
हमारी वायुसेना ने दुश्मनों के हवाई अड्डों पर जवाबी हमला बोल दिया.
Destroy or capture the Pakistani army of occupation and liberate Bangladesh.
Liberate Bangladesh.
The Indian forces knock out over 52 Pakistani military aircraft and 90 tanks.
And give a round of huge applause, please. Pakistan, now Bangladesh. I was a young second lieutenant having won Lemon Drop Star in the Western Sector. But General Cardozo has been a legend in the army. We keep hearing about his stories. During the assault, when his leg got blown off in a mine blast, it was dangling. And on the radio set, the higher quarter asked him to be evacuated. The doctor said, "Sir, your leg has to be amputated." So he asked simply, I believe, "What does it involve?" "Just chopping off the leg." He just took a vial of morphine injections from his pouch, injected himself, tied a tourniquet, took a kukri from his Gurkha soldier and just chopped off and told him, "Go and bury it, but take me to the objective." That was a kind of officers we had. So we are indeed grateful to you for addressing this August gathering today. Now the question is, in Mangalore being a we being a very rare specimen, we are called as Maji Sainikaru, retired people. Sorry, we are to be addressed as a veterans. Veteran means one who has gone through the rigmarole of all these things. Now, what is a veteran? A veteran is the one who at some stage of his life has pledged everything to the nation. In that pledge, it included his life. That means it's something like issuing a blank check. And that check has no expiry date. Many of us, like Vasant Kumar and Commander Mascarenhas, when they issued that check pledging their life to the nation, he was 16 years old. He was 17 years old. Am I right, sir? Am I right, sir? Yes. Pledging, when you pledge your life,
you put your hand on your holy book. It could be a Bible, it could be a Quran, it could be a Granth Sahib, or it could be the holy Bhagavad Gita. And you say, till my last breath, I'll complete the orders given to me by the President of India. I'll be willing to move by air, by sea, or by land, or underwater. Down the years, it is unimaginable that 53 years ago, I pledged my life to the nation, and as a young graduate, I entered the portals of the academy for training, a rigorous training. While doing the battle assault course, where the cadets are made to go under automatic medium machine gun fire, smoke, blast of explosives, some cadets get scared. The instructor is shouting at us, Pakistan ki ordnance ki, but that instructor probably didn't realize this GC will be hit. This is fast, infested by leeches and several malarial mosquitoes, altitudes. In wherein they had already declared at 14,500 feet. Wants to stay with me in Leh, plastered with mud to prevent from minus 38 to minus 37. Early morning, your orderly has to come on fire because the entire water in the bathroom has frozen. It has to burn. Friction area. Band of brothers. We are proud of our relatives, proud of a vast and diverse culture of them. There is no need to give us any lecture on battle, stab, or what do you feel? I said, I felt envious of thee. Their name is written in golden letters, whereas here we are, we failed. Such extremes. When we entered the academy, portals of the training academy, and a huge granite wall, Field Marshal Sir Philip Chetwood, this is being passed out as officers. Incidentally, Field Marshal Manekshaw was the first cadet, and he was for Burmese Army, other was General Musa. The Supreme Commander of the Indian Army, Armed Forces. Your country comes first, always. The safety, honor, safety, comfort, and honor. In the evening, you must be having toast, right? No. You turn back, the pages of your days gone by, and some of the questions, you are searching for answers which have not got the answer so far. In 71 war, in front of me, as the battle was raging on, firing with their carbines from the hip, lobbing grenades, stabbing dark unseen bodies with the bayonet, there was this lion-hearted Major Tirup Singh. He was supposed to go and capture the last length piece of the objective. He was leading his 110 men. By the time he went there, heavy casualties, injuries, he was left with half the company. Around 3 o'clock, Pakistanis launched a major counterattack to recapture, repulsed it. Second counterattack, repulsed it. By then, he was left with just 10 able-bodied men. He was like a Sher of Punjab, a Sardar. When the third counterattack came with 60 Pakistani soldiers, he knew that he cannot hold this position anymore. They fought for the ashes of their forefathers. They fought for the temples of their gods. They fought for the precious piece of land on which you are living now. When you go back home, you'll be sleeping in comfort within the confines of the wall. But go to Siachen at 21,000 feet, a soldier will be standing with double coats and mittens and trigger guard of the MMG remote so that he can pull the trigger looking through the infrared equipment. The more you think of the soldier, more endearing he becomes. So much so, I ended up every morning when I light the incense stick, I pray for him, his wife, his children and his parents. I request you, when you go to temple or go to your God, just add a word about the Indian soldier who is protecting you there. He's an unknown face.
Other dignitaries among the audience, all dear soldiers, ladies and gentlemen, freedom in mind, faith in words, pride in our heart, memories in our souls. Let us salute the nation on this Republic Day. Best wishes and hearty compliments to each one of you on this auspicious 72nd Republic Day. Indian soldiers, when we utter these two words, our head gets down with respect and gratitude for their sacrifice and dignity. From the icy terrain of Himalayas to the scorching heat of in the desert, they guard us and their family all day and night without any complaints. From the dawn of our independence, they keep us guarding from the intruders, terrorists and other external attacks. Since 1947, we have faced three major wars, and in each case, even in worse conditions, we have snatched victory from the enemies with the help of our powerful, devotional and extremely talented Indian Army, Navy and Air Force. Nobody merits the title of a legend more than a fighter. The fearless men and women at the Indian Armed Forces stay far from their families, miss many huge things in their lives and forfeit their lives simply so you can be with your friends and family and rest calmly during the evenings. On the off chance that there is a paradise, these are the men and women who merit the most elevated platform. Truly portrays the spirit of dedication, patriotism and sacrifice. Believing in one religion, that is service towards nation, our brave soldiers bear freezing temperatures and scorching heat to keep our borders safe from the enemy. Away from their own loved ones, they give us all the occasion to be ours. They make the supreme sacrifice without thinking twice. A soldier says, I'm a soldier, I fight where I'm told, and I win where I fight. This is the unlimited courage and undying compassion of our motherland. Glorious Indian forces today, tomorrow and forever. And this is the mantra of each soldier. No agony, no pain shall make me cry. Soldier, I was born. Soldier, shall I die? I live by chance, love by choice, and killer by profession. We miss home because we save homes. On behalf of all of us, let me raise the toast in the words of an old greeting. May your troubles be less, may your blessings be more, and may nothing but happiness comes through your door. Ladies and gentlemen, to all our brave soldiers, brave fauges, cheers and Jai Hind.
ಚೇಂಜ್ ಕಮಿಟಿ ಜಿಲ್ಲಾ ಸಂಚಾಲಕರಾದ ವಿಜಯ ವಿಷ್ಣುಮಯ್ಯ, ವಸಂತ್ ಕುಮಾರ್ ಶೆಟ್ಟಿ, ರೊನಾಲ್ಡ್ ಗೋಮ್ಸ್, ಮಹಮ್ಮದ್ ಇಕ್ಬಾಲ್, ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್ನ ನಂದಗೋಪಾಲ್, ಸಚಿತಾ ನಂದಗೋಪಾಲ್, ಮಂಗಳೂರು ಕೌನ್ಸಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಸಿವಿಲ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ನ ಅಧ್ಯಕ್ಷ ಅರುಣ್ ಪ್ರಭಾ ಮೊದಲಾದವರು ಉಪಸ್ಥಿತರಿದ್ದರು.
ಜಗದಾ ಮಂದಿರ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ವಿದ್ಯಾ ಪ್ರಕಾಶ ಸಾಸ आजा जिंदा शाम यानी के तले आजा जरी वाले नीले आसमान के तले जा हो जग दे इंडिया जग दे वंदे मातरम वंदे मातरम वंदे मातरम वंदे मातरम सुजलाम सुफलाम मलय शिवलाम सत्य श्यामलाम मातरम वंदे मातरम वंदे मातरम वंदे मातरम वंदे मातरम वंदे मातरम
ये दुनिया एक दुल्हन
ये दुनिया एक दुल्हन जो रंगे माजे की बिंदिया समझो दिल भर जानी जितना भी तुम समझोगे उतनी होगी हैरानी
तेरी दिल है हिंदुस्तानी जिनकी दिल है हिंदुस्तानी तेरी दिल है हिंदुस्तानी जिनकी दिल है हिंदुस्तानी
मेरा रंग दे
मिट्टी से तिलक करो ये धरती है बलिदान की
वंदे मातरम वंदे मातरम वंदे मातरम वंदे मातरम
ऐ मेरे प्यारे वतन बिछड़े चमन तुझ पे दे
Come on.